If these allegations are true, this could be the thing that is the final nail in the coffin of R. Kelly and his freedom and a lot of other things as well. A tape has surfaced, and it is allegedly R. Kelly in it with a different girl than the original tape that we knew of, and she is allegedly underage. Do you believe this? According to CNN, the tape is 42 minutes and 45 seconds long and contains two scenes with a man alleged to be R. Kelly and an underage girl. CNN says that they have watched this video with their own eyes. The people say that they have seen the person in this video apparently being R. Kelly and this underage girl. So there's no question. They also talk about that this is actually a clear video, not like the video that was seen back in the 2000s when he first ran into trouble with videotapes.
We've spoken to sources on this story, and I have also viewed the tape, and I can tell you that the video is graphic. It is clear. It is in a well-lit room.
Why are they saying that this is a girl? This is someone who is underage, according to CNN. But how can they know that? Do they know when the video was made? Did she show her ID, her school ID? How do they know that this is someone who is not of age and certainly not of the age of consent in Chicago, if this is where this has taken place? We know that sometimes people don't always look their age. A person can be older and look younger, and a person can be younger and look older. In the case of a lot of girls in their teens, they may actually look like they're older than their teens when they are, in fact, underage. So in this case, why are they so confident that this young lady is not of age?
The girl on this tape, she describes the age of her genitalia. She talks about her female genitalia. She describes it as being 14 years old, not once, but at least six different times.
So where did this VHS tape come from? Attorney Michael Avenatti, who is claiming to represent a man that he calls a whistleblower against R. Kelly, is the one who has released the tape. He's turned over a copy to the Cook County State's Attorney's Office in Chicago, and he gave a copy to CNN, which is how they saw this tape. But who is Michael Avenatti?
The combative attorney became a household name representing porn star Stormy Daniels.
Hi, everyone.
Now finding himself on the defense after he was arrested Wednesday on suspicions of domestic violence.
So that's right. He represents an adult film star, Stormy Daniels, or did at the time, in her accusations against President Donald Trump. So Michael Avenatti takes on these high-profile cases, and now, in this case, he's turned over that VHS tape to the Cook County State's Attorney's Office, who already had a case open against R. Kelly. In early 2019, State's Attorney Kim Fox came forward and asked for the public's help.
I'm here today to encourage victims of sexual assault or domestic violence related to these allegations to please get in touch with our office.
In a statement, Michael Avenatti said, "My client knows the identity of the girl and R. Kelly. He identified the two of them on the videotape. He worked for and has known R. Kelly for decades, and he met the girl on a number of occasions." The reason that the original case against R. Kelly failed had to do with authenticity. Was that R. Kelly in that grainy tape? Well, the jurors said that they had doubt that it was R. Kelly. The defense said perhaps it was even R. Kelly's brother. In that case, the question was whether or not it was R. Kelly in that tape. And that question couldn't be answered with all certainty. And was it the girl that they thought it was in that tape? She didn't testify in the trial, so there was nothing that said that this was the girl other than other people identifying her in that tape. But that wasn't enough for the jury. We all know about Sparkle, who says that this was in fact her niece in the tape, but there were also other family members who said that it wasn't her niece.
there was the argument made about who was on the tape. Was the person underage? Was it even R. Kelly? The reason I say that, Anna, is because I predict that the same arguments will be made here.
Exactly. Those same arguments will be made, but they'll be made for different reasons. This time, the question won't be whether or not it's R. Kelly or someone else in that tape. It'll be whether or not it's R. Kelly or was the tape actually faked.
We are in a day and age of technology where things can be placed upon tapes that may look one way but are quite another.
Have you ever heard the term deepfake?
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time.
Seeing is not believing anymore. President Barack Obama never said these lines. You're hearing actor and comedian Jordan Peele's voice imitating Obama, lip-synced to an existing video clip. It's a so-called deepfake.
Deepfake is an artificial intelligence-based technology that's used to produce or alter video content so that it presents something that didn't actually occur, making it look like it actually did. The word is a combination of deep learning and fake. So back to authenticity. In that first case against R. Kelly, it came down to whether or not that was really him in the tape. With this new tape, CNN mentions a mole. But why a mole in 2019? Why are they talking about a mole on the back of the person in that video? If the tape is as clear as they say it is, there are tons of ways that you could identify a person. So why are they talking about this mole? To understand this, you got to go back to the original case. There was a great debate over whether or not the person in the video had a mole on their back. There was something on the video that appeared to be on the back of the person at times, would appear and disappear. But the question was that really a mole or was it VHS tape distortion due to the fact that the tape had been copied so many times? There were experts who said this was due to distortion and was not a mole. So when you look at CNN mentioning that in the tape, they with their own eyes saw that a person had a mole on their lower back on the left side, they're trying to get out in front and say, this time we really know it's R. Kelly because he's got a mole and there's no question that there's a mole there in this video. R. Kelly has a number of tattoos on his body, on his forearms, at least we know that he's got tattoos. So there should be some tattoos visible in this video too. Why didn't CNN mention any tattoos? Why didn't they mention anything else that could have possibly identified the person in the video as R. Kelly? And why won't they come out and just say that the person in the video looks exactly like R. Kelly in the face? There really wouldn't be much backlash because most people think he's guilty anyway. It is completely understandable with all of the allegations against him that something just doesn't smell right in his camp. But the question here is whether or not this video is authentic or whether or not it's been faked. Is this a deep fake video or is this real? How do we figure that out in 2019 and beyond? The video will probably never be released for public scrutiny and analysis. And, well, R. Kelly may not have as much money as he used to have to afford a defense that can figure out and analyze the film to find out whether or not this has been altered or if it is real. The girl may need to come forward in order for there to be a conviction in this case. In the state of Illinois, there is currently no statute of limitations for prosecuting and reporting offenses of this nature against children. That means anything that happened, if they were under 18, can be reported and prosecuted even now. None of this is happening in a bubble. It's been months and even years of the Mute R. Kelly campaign working to make sure that his music is not listened to, working to try to stop his concerts, and working to make sure that his alleged victims actually receive justice. Do you think that R. Kelly is going to be prosecuted and convicted for this tape? We want to know whether you think he will actually be convicted, not whether you hope he'll be convicted, not whether he deserves to be convicted, but do you think that the evidence in this case is going to be able to prove to a jury that R. Kelly was in this tape having relations with an underage girl? Go to the comments and let us know what you think about this. If you're not subscribed to Axiom Amnesia, be sure to subscribe to the channel and let us know what you think. Also, hit the bell so you'll know immediately when we post a new video.